हाय, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर सेफ एट होम. स्कूल मैनेजमेंट हैज गिवन मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टेक क्लास, 9th grade क्लास, सोशल साइंस. सो टुडे वी कैन लर्न अबाउट ज्योग्राफी लेसन 1. सो ज्योग्राफी इन दिस पोर्शन देर आर 8 यूनिट्स. दे आर lithosphere 1, endogenic processes, lithosphere 2, exogenic processes, atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere, man and environment, mapping skills, disaster management, responding to disaster. So today we can learn about unit 1, lithosphere 1, endogenic processes. So from this lesson only there are 7 topics, simple topics are there. So students, please listen carefully and take notes also. So first one, spheres of the earth. Second, structure of the earth. Third, rock. Fourth, earthquake. Fifth, seismic waves. Sixth one, tsunami. And seventh, volcanoes. Now introduction. So Earth, which is the unique planet of the solar family, that is the Earth. You all know that unique planet means where the planet, where all the things, air, water, atmosphere, everything have in this. So Earth is considered as the unique planet of the solar family. So this next one, the Earth is composed of 4 spheres. Do you all know which are the 4 spheres? They are lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere. So mainly this lesson, lithosphere has focuses the internal process of the earth. What it has done in this lesson, mainly we have learned about the internal process of the earth. So lithosphere, what do you mean by lithosphere? What is the meaning for lithosphere? Litho means rock, sphere means round in shape. It is the rock, ball in shape. So lithosphere, why you can see the lithosphere on the earth means lithosphere is the solid outer part of the earth. So atmosphere means is a thin layer of gases that surrounds the earth. Lithosphere means what? What is the lithosphere? Lithosphere is the solid outer part of the earth. Atmosphere means thin layer of gases that surround the earth. Hydrosphere is the watery part of the earth's surface, including oceans, rivers, lakes and water vapor. Next, the biosphere is the layer of earth where life exists. So once again I am saying the lithosphere is the solid outer part of the earth. The atmosphere is a thin layer of gases that surrounds the earth. Next one, the hydrosphere is the watery part. That means why we can see this water on the earth's surface? It includes oceans, rivers, lakes and water vapor. Next, the biosphere is the layer of earth where life exists, where there only we are living, that is the earth. Next, first one, spheres of the earth. So earth's surface is a vast area. Vast area means very large area. It is about 510 million square kilometer. So how many square kilometer? 510 million square kilometer. So it is a vast area. And there are 4 spheres of earth interact. So here, earth, how many spheres? Earth was divided into how many spheres? Already I told that earth was divided into 4 spheres. What are they? Atmosphere, biosphere, hydrosphere and lithosphere. So these 4 spheres are divided into 2 spheres. That one is abiotic spheres and biotic spheres. So the abiotic spheres are the lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere. Biotic sphere is the biosphere. So now, abiotic, what do you mean by abiotic and what do you mean by biotic? Abiotic means while life is not exist, we can't live. Biotic means life exists, where we can live. So, for example, if we have only land, whether we can live or not? No, we can't. Yes. So, we need all these three things. So, suppose if we are now having only gas, we can't live. At the same time, only water, we can't live. So, all these three things are very, very important for our life. So, where we can see all these three things means in the biosphere. So, all these three things are together, three spheres are together called as the biotic sphere. So, biotic sphere is the biosphere. Together, these spheres consist only in which planet we can see all these three spheres? The Earth. Next, do you know who has divided this Earth into four spheres? That is the orbit homes. So, Earth can physically be described as a ball of rock. Ball of rock means what? Lithosphere. Lithosphere means what? It is the ball of rock. Next, hydrosphere. It is covered by water. At the same time, atmosphere means it is covered by air. So, to these three physical zones, it is convenient to add a biological zone which include all the living organisms. Biological, biological means what? All living organisms are there. That is considered as the biosphere. So, Arthur Holmes only divided this Earth into four spheres. He only named this Earth as four spheres. That is the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and the biosphere. Next topic is the structure of the Earth. Now, if you see this picture, in this picture, what you understood, the Earth was divided into three layers. What are the three important layers? Crust, mantle, core. So, if you see this picture, the outer surface of the Earth and the inner core are not the same. They are totally different in their nature and structure. So, the structure of the Earth's interior is divided into three layers, namely the crust, the mantle and the core. Next, there is one box. Do you know that the term lithosphere and crust are not the same? They are all different. The term lithosphere and crust are not the same. The lithosphere includes the crust and uppermost part of the mantle. So, which one was included in the uppermost part of the mantle? Lithosphere. Lithosphere includes the crust and the uppermost part of the mantle. So, all terrestrial planets have lithosphere. Now, terrestrial planets. What is the meaning for terrestrial? Terrestrial means it's the planet nearer to the sun. Okay, students. So, all terrestrial planets have lithosphere. So, the lithosphere, which are the planets nearer to the sun? They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. So, these are the planets nearer to the sun. So, lithosphere of Mercury, Venus and Mars are much thicker and more rigid than that of the Earth. So, sometimes they may ask one word question from this observer. So, be careful. And they may ask question like this. Which planet was more thicker and more rigid than the other planet? That means, lithosphere of Mercury, Venus and Mars are much thicker and more rigid than that of the Earth. So, in this Mercury, Venus, Mars only, lithosphere, the rock is more thicker and more rigid, more hard than that of the Earth. Rigid means very hard, kadinamaga. Okay. Next topic is the crust. Now, the crust, you all know, it is the outer layer of the Earth, where we live. So, it is also considered as the skin of the Earth. Sometimes they may ask question also, which is called as the skin of the Earth. So, which was considered as the skin of the student? Crust. So, it ranges between 5 to 30 kilometer. It is the solid and rigid layer of the Earth. So, crust is called as a solid and rigid layer of the Earth. Next topic, mandal. Mandal, what you can understand about this mandal, it is the interior part beneath the crust is called mandal, which is about 2900 kilometer thick. So the major element of mandal are silica and magnesium, and hence it is also termed as sima. So this mantle, how much kilometer thick? It is 2900 kilometer thick. Why it was it is the interior part beneath the crust is called mantle, which is about 2900 kilometer thick. So which are the elements you can see in this mantle, students? So which are the elements? Silica and magnesium. So it is termed as sima. So in the upper part of the mantle, the rock remains solid, whereas in the lower part of the mantle, rock are in molten form. So this mantle, there are two parts, upper part and upper mantle and lower mantle. So this upper mantle, the rock will be solid, where the lower mantle, rocks are in molten form. Molten, what is the meaning for molten? Molten means it is the watery form. This molten rock inside the earth is called magma. Which is called, what is called magma? It is the molten rock inside the earth is called magma. So once again we can recall about mantle. There are two types of mantle. What are they? Upper mantle and lower mantle. It was divided into two parts. Upper mantle, lower mantle. So where this rocks are very solid, it was seen in the lower part of the mantle. And where you can see the rocks are in the molten form, the upper part of the mantle the rocks remain solid, whereas in the lower part of the mantle rocks in the molten form. So molten rock inside the earth is called magma. Next, do you understand? So it is 2900 kilometer thick. At the same time, what are the elements seen in the mantle? Magnesium and silica. So it is also called as sima. So this mantle was divided into two parts, upper mantle, lower mantle. Upper mantle is solid, lower mantle is molten form. Next topic. So from this lesson we can understand this picture, how much kilometer? 2900 kilometer. Next, core. Here also it is divided into two, outer core and inner core. So it is one of the most hottest layer of the earth, which lies below mantle. The core is the innermost and hottest layer of the earth. Someday they may ask question, which is the hottest layer of the earth? It is the core. Yes. So where this core was, core is the in below the mantle, and it is also innermost layer of the earth, which lies below the mantle. It is composed mainly of nickel and iron. Hence it is called gneiss. Knife, N-I-F-E, knife means nickel and iron. So this core is divided into solid inner core and liquid outer core. So this inner core will be solid and outer core will be liquid. So the presence of large, why this core is contain more iron means due to the earth's gravitational force. There only the iron in the core is responsible for the earth's gravitational force. All know our earth is rotate on its axis. The presence of, so if the earth rotate on its axis, how this earth is rotate on its axis? The liquid outer core spins over the solid inner core and generates the earth's magnetic field, so that only earth is rotating on its axis. So listen, the core is divided into two, inner and outer. inner core is solid and outer core is liquid, and at the same time it is composed mainly of nickel and iron, so hence it is called knife. So it is, the core is the innermost and hottest layer of the earth, which lies below the mantle. So how this earth is getting gravitational force, we all know, because of the content of the iron, lot of iron inside the core. At the same time, it produces a magnetic field also. How it has produced magnetic field means, actually the earth is rotating on its axis. While it is rotating on its axis, the liquid outer core spins over the solid inner core. Spins. What is the meaning for spins? It is rotating. At that time, what will generate means, Earth's magnetic field will generate. Like this only, this Earth's magnetic field is generating. So this is responsible for the functioning of the magnetic compass also. Due to high pressure and materials in the inner core are unable to move and hence remain solid. So please students, once again we can recall core. Core means, you know, it is the innermost part of the earth, and also it is one of the hottest layer of the earth, and it is composed of nickel and iron, and this core is divided into two. What are they? Inner core and outer core. So inner core is solid in nature and outer core is liquid in nature. So this core, the presence of large quantity of iron is there. Due to large quantity of iron, it is responsible for the earth's gravitational force. So sometimes they may ask question, why this gravitational force is generated in the earth? In which layer generate earth's gravitational force? That is the core. As the earth rotates on its axis, the liquid outer core spins over the solid inner core and generate the earth's magnetic field. Next question also they may ask, how this magnetic field has generated? How this magnetic field generates? How means, the earth is rotating on its axis. Axis means what? Axis. That we all know that. How this earth is rotating? Earth rotates on its axis. How in this two core, inner core and outer core, the liquid outer core spins over the solid inner core. Due to that only, what was generating, what was producing? Earth's magnetic field was producing. Okay. Next, this is responsible for functioning of magnetic compass also, which was responsible this core. Due to high pressure, the material is the inner core are unable to move and hence remain solid. So what happened means, due to earth pressure, high pressure, the material, which are the materials present in the core? Nickel and iron. This material are unable to move and hence remain solid. They are unable to move. Unable means they can't move. So what happened? It will remain solid. Okay, do you understand? Next topic we can go on. Rocks. What do you mean by rock? Rock means, you all know in Tamil, paarigal, isn't it? So the crust is the storehouse of rocks. Which is the storehouse of rock? Where you can find more rocks? On the uppermost layer of the earth. Which is the uppermost layer of the earth? The crust. Which is the crust is the storehouse of the rock. So in this crust, an aggregate of minerals on the earth crust is called rock. That means the total mineral, many minerals, more minerals on the earth crust is called rock. It may be hard and compact like granite, or soft as clay, or loose as sand. Granite. Granite means we are putting for the houses. It will be very hard. And some rocks are very soft, they are considered as clay. And some are loose, it is considered as sand. So the crust or storehouse of rocks, so which is the storehouse? Rocks are classified as igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. So what are the types of rocks? There are three types of rocks: igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and metamorphic rock. So there is one fact. There are many species of magnificent rock cut architecture in India, like the Ajanta and Ellora cave in Maharashtra, the Ehole and Badami temple in Karnataka, the Konark temple in Odisha, and Mamallapuram in Tamil Nadu. So these places, they have created, with the help of the rock, they have created the many caves, temples, etc. Only with the help of the rock, they have cut this rock as a single specimen of rock cut temple. That is like Ajanta and Ellora caves in where it was situated in Maharashtra, and Ehole and Badami temple where it is in Karnataka, and Konark temple is in Odisha, and the Mamallapuram rock cut temple where it was situated in Tamil Nadu. Next one, igneous rock. On seeing this picture, what do you understand? This igneous rock, it is like a fire. Okay, also what is the another name for this igneous rock? Fire. So the word igneous is derived from the Latin word ignis, meaning fire. That means what? It is like a fire. So the interior of the earth contains very hot molten material called magma. So first, from the interior of the earth, very hot molten, due to the pressure and heat, what will come out? Where hot molten material, that is called as magma. When the magma reaches the earth's surface, it is referred to as lava. Same magma, when it reaches the surface of the earth, it is referred to as lava. So the interior of the earth contains very hot molten material called magma. When this magma reaches the earth's surface, it is referred to as lava. So the lava on the surface, what it will do means it will cool and get solidified as rock. That is called as igneous rock. So once again, I'm saying how this igneous rock was formed. When this hot molten material is called magma, when this magma reaches the surface of the earth, it is called lava. So the lava on the surface cools down and gets solidified as rock, and it is called igneous rock. It will change to rock. So the word igneous, from where it was derived from? From means it was derived from the Latin word ignis. Ignis means what? Fire. So it will be always very hot. It will be like a hot molten material, that is called magma. So magma reaches surface, means surface of the earth, it was named as lava. When this lava was cool and it gets solidified, it will change as a rock. That rock was named as igneous rock. Not only granite and basalt are the examples of the igneous rocks. So igneous rocks are also called as primary or mother rock. Why it is considered as primary or mother rock? Because all other rocks are directly or indirectly formed from them. Students, please listen. Igneous rocks are also called as primary or mother rock. Sometimes they may ask question, which rock was called as primary rock or mother rock? Igneous rock. Or the answer is igneous rock. Why it is considered as the primary or mother rock means because all other rocks are directly or indirectly formed from them. From this, the main rock is the igneous. From this rock only, other two rocks also form. Which are the other two rocks? Sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. Okay. Next rock, sedimentary rock. You see this picture, how this sedimentary rock was formed. So these sedimentary rocks are named after the Latin word sediment, meaning settle. Settle. What is the meaning? Sediment means settle. In Tamil, we will say padivam. Okay. So, how these sedimentary rocks are formed? Few million years ago, many rivers, glaciers, and winds carry bits of rock and soil and deposit them in layers. So, what it will do means it will compact into rocks and are called sedimentary rocks. So, how these sedimentary rocks are formed? Many millions and millions of years ago, the rivers, glaciers, and winds carry bits of rock, which means small pieces of rocks and soil. And what they will do means it will deposit them in layers. After few million years ago, these deposits harden into compact rocks and are called sedimentary rocks. So, which will form as the sedimentary rock due to the rivers, glaciers, and winds? The rocks and soil are deposited them in layers. What will happen means, after a few million years ago, this deposit layers will become as a hardened one. Hardened and into compact rocks and are called sedimentary rocks. In Tamil, we will say padiva paarai. Okay. Next, the bodies of the plants and animals that fall on the deposit get embedded into the layers and form fossils. Okay. How these fossils are formed? Along with this rivers, glaciers, winds, many bits of rocks and soil are also carrying. Along with that, what also will carry? It will carry bodies of dead plants and animals. Okay, it will also deposit and get embedded in the layers and form fossils. Sandstone, limestone, chalk, gypsum, coal and colgamate are examples of sedimentary rocks. So, which are the examples of sedimentary rocks? Sandstone, limestone, chalk, gypsum, coal and colgamate are examples of sedimentary rocks. Okay, students, did you understand? Next topic, metamorphic rock. On seeing this picture, what you understand? Metamorphic rock, like a granite, isn't it? What we have put in your house. The term metamorphic is derived from the word metamorphosis, which means change of form. What do you mean by the term metamorphic? Change of form. So, this metamorphic means what? What is the meaning? Change of form. When igneous or sedimentary rocks are subjected to extreme heat and pressure, they undergo a complete change in their form and character. Due to that only, what rock was formed? Metamorphic rock was formed. Due to extreme heat and pressure, it will undergo a complete change in their form and character. So, what this rock will form? Metamorphic rock will form. In course of time, granite may get transformed to gneiss, basalt to schist, limestone to marble, and sandstone to quartz. So, how this metamorphic? The term metamorphic is derived from the word metamorphosis. What is the meaning for metamorphosis? Metamorphosis means change of form. So, how it change means, so when igneous or sedimentary rocks are subjected to extreme heat and pressure, due to heat and pressure only, they undergo a complete change in their form and character. So, like that only, the metamorphic rock was formed. Next topic, rock cycle. Rock cycle, what do you mean by rock cycle? Rock cycle is a continuous process through which igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic rocks are transformed from one form to another. What do you mean by rock cycle? Rock cycle is a continuous process through which igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock are transformed from one form to another form. That only the rock cycle. So, from this picture also you can understand easily. From this igneous rock, slow uplift of the surface and transport and deposit. Next, sedimentary rock, burial, high temperature and pressure. Next, it will form metamorphic rock. geomorphic processes. What do you mean by geomorphic processes? From this picture, you can understand there are many landforms also there. The forces that act on the Earth's interior towards the Earth's surface are called internal processes or endogenic processes. So these forces build the landscape and create topography relief. So the forces that act on the surface of the Earth due to natural agents like running water, glacier, wind, wave, etc. are called external processes or exogenic processes. These external processes tear the landscape down into relatively low elevated planes and shapes the landform created by endogenic processes. So this running water, glaciers, wind, waves, etc. are called external processes or exogenic processes. So the force that act on the surface of the Earth due to natural agents are called as external processes or exogenic processes. So under this geomorphic processes, next heading is internal processes. What do you mean by internal processes? The internal processes generate heat and eject materials from deep below the Earth's crust. Internal radioactivity is the principal source of power for this process. So, internal processes, what it will generate means, it will generate heat and eject materials from deep below the Earth's crust. From the deep below the Earth's crust only, it will generate heat and eject materials. So internal radioactivity is the principal source of power for this processes. So sometimes they may ask question, which is the principal source of power for this internal processes? That is the radioactivity. Internal radioactivity is the principal source of power for this processes. Okay students, next topic is the plate tectonic. What do you mean by this plate tectonic? Plate tectonic means some plate, it will move forward, some will move side like that. From this picture, what you can understand means both these plates, the where you can see this plate means on the crust, outermost layer of the Earth. There only we can see the plate. This is moving forward. What will happen due course? The plate tectonic, the lithosphere is divided into a number of huge slabs of rocks called tectonic plates. So what is called, how these tectonic plates are formed, or what is called the tectonic plate means the lithosphere. Lithosphere means outermost surface of the Earth, isn't it? It is divided into a number of huge slabs of rocks. It is called tectonic plate. These tectonic plates are divided into major and minor plates. That small and or bigger plates. These plates float independently over the mantle. Where it will be float independently. Independently means tanithu over the mantle. At the time, what will happen means the collusion. Collusion means what? It will be a dash of this plate produce mountain ranges and other irregular surface features, both on land and the ocean floor. So in this ocean floor or in the continental floor, what will happen means if this plate have got collusion means it will produce mountain. So students, how this mountain range was formed, do you know how these mountain ranges are formed? Because of the collusions of the plates. Because of the collusions of the plates only the mountain ranges are formed. Okay, both on the land and also on the oceans. This phenomena is called plate tectonics. So the movement of tectonic plate is due to thermal energy from the mantle. So how this plate was moving? Because of what? What energy? Due to the thermal energy. So this phenomena is called plate tectonic. So once again I can recall, what do you mean by plate tectonic? That means the movement of tectonic plates. Why this plate was moving? For what is the reason? What was the reason? Due to the thermal energy. From what this thermal energy was produced? From the mantle. So from the mantle, due to thermal energy, the movement of tectonic plates, what was formed? Plate tectonic was formed. You understand? So the lithosphere is divided into number of huge slabs of rock called tectonic plates. These tectonic plates are divided into two types. What are they? Major plate and minor plate. So what will happen means these plates float independently over the mantle. Independently means what is tanithu. So at that time what happen means two plates will be collision will occur. Collision means it will be dash. At that time only the mountain was formed and are irregular surface features both on land on the ocean floor. So next topic, types of plate boundaries. There are three types of plate boundaries. They are convergent boundary, divergent boundary, conservative or transform boundary. Students, please listen. What are the types of plate boundaries? There are three types of plate boundaries. What are they? They are convergent boundary, divergent boundary, conservative or transform boundary. Now, one by one, we can see in detail. First one, convergent boundary. Convergent. What do you mean by that? Converge. Convergent means the plate which are moving towards each other. So, convergent boundary, here the plates move towards each other and sometimes a plate sinks under another. From this picture also you can understand. One plate was moving inside the another plate. So the location where the sinking of a plate occurs is called a subduction zone. What was that? What was the location where the plate, one plate was dash another plate and it was going inside the plate is called a subduction zone. Example, we can say as fold mountain, that is Himalayas. Fold mountain, which was considered as a fold mountain, Himalayas. So what are the types of plate boundaries? Convergent plate boundary, divergent boundary, conservative or transform boundary. So first one, convergent boundary. Convergent boundary, here the plate moves towards each other and sometimes a plate sinks under another. So this location where the sinking of the plate occurs is called a subduction. For example, we can say for this convergent boundary, it is the fold mountain, that is the Himalayan. Himalayan mountain is considered as the convergent boundary. Next topic is divergent boundary. From the wording itself, you can understand diverge. Diverge means they are separating, they are moving in the opposite direction. So here the plates pull away from each other as magma pushes up from the mantle. Example, mid-Atlantic ridge. So divergent boundary, from the picture also you can understand, diverge. Diverge means from the ridge, it is diverge, it is moving apart. So here the plates pull away from each other as magma pushes up from the mantle. So example, mid-Atlantic ridge. Next topic, third one is the conservative or transform boundary. Next topic what? Conservative or transform boundary. So here the plates slide horizontally past each other. Okay, it one, it is here the plates slide horizontally. Horizontally means what? One was moving front and another was moving back. Like that it was horizontally past each other. Example, San Andreas Fault. So once again we can recall, what are the types of plate boundaries? Convergent boundary, divergent boundary, conservative or transform boundary. So convergent boundary means the plates are moving, both moving towards them, and divergent means it is opposite. Okay, conservative means it is moving horizontally. So next one, earthquake. Earthquake, what do you know about earthquake? You all know. The earthquake is the sudden vibration of the earth crust. What do you mean by earthquake? Earthquake means what? It is the sudden vibration. Next topic is earthquake. Earthquakes are generally caused by the sudden vibrations of the earth crust, which spread outward in all direction as waves from the source of disturbance. So how these earthquakes are caused? It was caused by the sudden vibration of the earth. Okay, actually this, it was spread outside in all the direction as waves from the source of disturbance. The next point is the point of origin of an earthquake is called focus. Focus means hypocenter, which generates a series of elastic waves. Okay, what this focus has generate? Elastic waves. So this epicenter means what? Is a point on the earth surface that lies directly above the focus. Above the point, exactly the center of the point is called as the focus. So the impact of earthquake is felt the most as the epicenter. So this next topic is seismic waves. This seismic waves are divided into three types, that is S wave, P wave and L wave. Okay, so seismic waves, from this picture we can understand that P wave arrive at 0.57 seconds, S wave maximum amplitude 2.7 millimeter per second, S waves arrive 8.7 seconds, S waves minimum amplitude is -2.8 millimeter per second. So seismic waves, earthquakes generate seismic waves. Which generate seismic waves? Earthquake. Students, sometimes they may ask question, which wave will generate seismic waves? Earthquake. Due to earthquake only, which wave was generating seismic waves was generating. So the seismic waves, the nature, force and speed depend on the nature of the medium through which it passes. So the seismic waves through which it was depend means because of nature, force and the speed. How much speed it was moving, according to that only it was dependent. Next, accordingly there are three major types of waves. We all know what are the three major types of waves. They are the P waves, L waves and S waves. So primary or P waves are the fastest of all the earthquake waves and first to reach the epicenter. So which wave will reach the epicenter first? Primary or P waves. So this P waves are the fastest of all the earthquake waves. So it only reach the epicenter first. These waves passes through solid, liquid and gas, either through pull or push with an average velocity of 5.3 km per second to 10.6 km per second. So students, we can recall once again seismic waves. Seismic waves, here the P waves are the fastest of all the earthquake. Among the three waves, which wave is the fastest of all the earthquake waves? Primary waves. It only reach the epicenter first. So how much average velocity it took me? 5.3 km per second to 10.6 km per second. So what these waves will pass means if these waves pass through solid, liquid and gases. Next one, secondary or S waves. Second wave. Second wave is the secondary or S waves. The secondary or S waves travel through only on the in solids. These transverse waves shake the ground perpendicular to the direction in which they propagate. The average velocity of the wave is 1 km per second to 8 km per second. Okay. So secondary wave is otherwise called as S waves. So where it will travel means it will travel only through solid. So sometimes you may ask question, which wave will travel only through solid? That is the secondary or S waves. So these waves, how it will be happen means it will shake the ground perpendicular to the direction in which they propagate. Okay, the average velocity, how much it is, means for 1 kilometer per second to 8 kilometer per second, this average velocity of this wave you have calculated. Next one, surface waves are L waves. So surface waves is also called as the L waves. From this picture, clearly you can understand P waves, S waves, surface waves. Okay. Next one, L waves. Surface waves. What is another name for surface waves? L waves. So surface waves or L waves are similar to P waves. Both are same, but they travel primarily along the ground surface. Okay. These waves travel comparatively slower and are the most destructive waves. So the average velocity of these waves are 1 kilometer per second to 5 kilometer per second. So sometimes they may ask for the max the following also. How much kilometer per second the S waves will travel? 1 kilometer per second to 8 kilometer per second, and also the surface waves 1 kilometer per second to 5 kilometer per second, like that. Okay. So how many types of waves are there? Seismic waves. There are 3 types of seismic waves. What are they? S waves, P waves, and L waves. Okay. Next one. Next topic we can learn about this tsunami. What do you know about tsunami? Tsunami is a it is a word. Tsunami is a Japanese term. Tsunami means what? A Japanese term meaning harbor waves. The word tsunami is a Japanese term meaning harbor waves. So it is generated, seismically it is generated in the sea waves caused by earthquake, submarine explosion and landslide. Due to this landslide or earthquake only, the tsunami will occur. These waves travel at a great speed, more than 500 km per hour, and the length of the wave exceeds 600 km. So do you know how much height it will be reaching? 15 meters near the seashore, and it will cause more destruction also. So tsunami, what do you know about commonly? What do you know about tsunami? Tsh means harbor, nami means waves. So it is called as harbor waves. The word tsunami is a Japanese term meaning harbor waves. They already have learned in the lower class, isn't it? It is adapted to describe large seismically generated sea waves caused by earthquake, submarine explosion and landslide. Because of the tsunami, what will happen? What that means, it will happen earthquake also. Sometimes submarine explosions also will happen. Sometimes large landslides also will happen due to this tsunami. So these waves travel, how much speed it was traveling, what was the length of the wave, or what was the speed? 500 km per hour. What was the length? 600 km. So these waves reached a height, how much height it was moving, means mostly 15 meters near the seashore, and are capable of causing destruction along the coastal area. Now recently in India also, tsunami has happened. In which year? 2004. Indian Ocean earthquake caused tsunami is the 6th deadliest natural disaster, which travel at a speed of 600 km per hour. So mostly approximately how many people are died? 280,000. The earthquake which occurred near Indonesia at 12:58 hours took nearly 7 hours to reach Chennai. At first, it was happened in Indonesia. Next only, it has reached to Chennai within 7 hours. So when it was happened? In 2004. Next one, volcanoes. You can see this picture, volcano. A volcano, what do you mean by a volcano? Volcano is a vent or an opening. Volcano means what? It is a vent or an opening on the surface of the earth crust through which, through with students, next topic, volcanoes. A volcano is a bench or an opening on the surface of the earth crust through which hot, solid, liquid and gaseous materials erupt out to the surface from the earth's interior. Magma rises up and ejects on the surface as lava. Volcanoes are also formed when plates move upwards. So what do you mean by volcano? Volcano is a vent or an opening on the earth crust. Okay. So through which here's a hot, solid, liquid and gaseous material, that is the magma, will come out, will erupt out the surface of the earth from the interior of the earth. So magma rises up and ejects on the surface. At the time, lava will produce. Volcanoes are also formed when plates move apart. So volcano, what is the meaning for volcano? There is one question also. Volcano is a bench. Bench means opening. Okay, bench or an opening on the surface. What this will happen means on the surface of the earth. How it will happen means through which hot, solid, liquid and gaseous material erupt out to the surface from the earth's interior. So this magma rises up and ejected on the surface as lava. At first from inside the earth it will be like a magma. While it is coming outside it will change to as lava. So volcanoes are also formed when plates move apart. Apart means when two plates move in the opposite directions. So here this volcanoes generally have the following major component. What are the components of volcano? They are magma chamber, bench, volcanic cone and crater. Okay, there are four major components of volcano. What are the four major components of volcano? Magma chamber, bench, volcanic cone and crater. So magma chamber, what do you mean by magma chamber? It is a large pool of liquid rock found beneath the surface of the earth. What do you mean by magma chamber? It is a large pool of liquid rock. The rock will be in the form of a liquid. Where it will be seen means it is under the surface of the earth. Next one is the bench. What do you mean by bench? Bench means opening. An opening we can see as an outlet for air, smoke, fumes, magma, etc. What is the use of this vent? Vent is an opening. For what purpose? For outlet of for air, smoke, fumes, magma, etc. Next one is the volcanic cone. A landform built by magma ejected from the vent in the shape of a cone is called volcanic cone. What do you mean by volcanic cone? It is a landform built by the magma ejected. Ejected means coming outside from the vent in the shape of a cone. So it is considered as volcanic cone. Next one, crater. Crater means it is a bowl shaped depression. What was that? It was a bowl shaped depression found at the top of the volcano through which the magma flows out. That is called as crater. So once again we can recall, there are four major components of volcano. What are the four major components of volcano? Magma chamber, vent, volcanic cone, crater. So what do you mean by magma chamber? It is a large pool of liquid rock. What do you mean by vent? It is an opening. What do you mean by volcanic cone? It is a landform built by magma. It was ejected from the vent in the shape of a cone. Next, what is meant by crater? It is a bowl-shaped depression found at the top of the volcano. Okay, students. Next one. Based on the periodic of eruption, volcanoes are classified into three types. So, what are the types of volcano? This volcano was classified into three types. They are active volcano, dormant volcano, extinct volcano. So there are three types of volcano. What are the three types of volcano, students? Active volcano, dormant volcano and the extinct volcano. So So one by one we can learn about this. What do you mean by active volcano? Active, what is the meaning for active? It is always very active volcano. Those which constantly eject volcanic lava gas and fragmented material, example mounds and islands in the United States. Next one is the dormant volcano or sleeping volcano. What do you mean by that? Volcano that do not show any sign of volcanic activity. It is for a long period of time are known as dormant volcano. Something they may be a sudden explosion which may cause unimaginable loss of life and property. Example, Mount Fuji, Japan. So it is also called as sleeping volcano. Next, third one is the extinct or dead volcano. What do you mean by that? When a volcano permanently stops its volcanic activity, then it is when a volcano permanently stops its volcanic activity, then it is called as extinct or dead volcano. Or you can see it is in the example Mount Kilimanjaro, that is in Thiruvannamalai, Tamil Nadu. Okay, thank you, students.